Because resistance is a very important property of any conductor and it is used in many useful ways in the practical application of electricity. So we will discuss further about resistance. So as I told you earlier, any component is represented as a resistor like this. Let's say these are the two points X and Y. It is any component, okay, metallic wire or any load. So the free electron passing through any resistor is actually experiencing retardation. Or if you imagine this with the obstacle race, if one person starts running from one point and it has to go through many obstacles on its way, this is something the resistance will represent. We will investigate further about the resistance of a conductor. What are the factors that resistance will depend upon? So to start with, any component is represented as a resistor here because it is offering some opposition to the movement of electrons through it. So resistor can be thought of like an obstacle race. The electron is passing through here and it has to cross the obstacles to come to the next point. And in this process, the moving electron will lose some of its energy as well. So very simply, with this we can say that resistance of a conductor will depend upon its length. If we have taken one length of a conductor and if we take double of its length, case A and case B. So here, imagine the obstacle race and here you imagine the obstacle race. So very simply, we can say that the resistance of a smaller wire will be smaller compared to the resistance of a longer wire. So the precise calculation will show that resistance of any material is proportionate to its length. The next case we will see cross section of the material wire. Again, very practically, you imagine if a car is passing through a single lane road and then it enters into the double lane road, what will happen? It will find moving much easier. It will experience less resistance. Similarly will be the case with the cross section of conductor. So if current is passing through a conductor of certain cross section and if the cross section of that conductor is doubled. So imagine a thin conductor to be a single lane road and a thick conductor to be the double lane road. Simply, the resistance of a thicker conductor will be lesser. So, we'll find that R is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area of the conductor. Clear? So, R depends on length as well as cross-section area of the conductor. Or if we bring them together, we can say R is proportional to L upon A. Or we introduce a constant of proportionality here, that is rho. We can say R is equal to rho L upon A. So, now we know the relationship that resistance of any conductor is equal to rho L, length of the conductor, over its cross-sectional area. This rho is known as resistivity. Resistivity of that conductor. Rho is a characteristic property of the material used. It is different from one material to the other material. SI unit of rho will be, you can see here, ohm, meter. So now we have discussed these two points. And the third point is resistance of a conductor depends upon the nature of material itself. As we discussed earlier, that there are good conductors, there are bad conductors, there are insulators. So that depends upon the nature of the material itself. So in terms of resistivity, if we discuss it, we will say the good conductors means low resistivity of that material, like metal and metal alloys. Then if we talk about the insulators, like glass or rubber, we will find that their resistivity is high. And another thing when we discuss about resistance and resistivity is the temperature of the material. You all agree that the temperature changes the lattice or the array of atoms in the conductor itself. that lattice of atom will affect the movement of the electron through it. So resistance and resistivity both depends on the temperature of the material itself. So there is another factor that affects resistance is temperature.